Hey, have you seen my multi-tool?
I think it's over there. Why?
I didn't want to leave without it.
Leave, Mick. We have to work on our script. It's due tomorrow.
It's fine. Look, I'll be back with plenty of time to finish the script up.
Where are you even going to go anyways?
I'm just going out. I'm gonna have a drink or two. We're not here for a while, so it's fine.
Oh, great. So when you get back, you'll be too fucked up to be of any use.
That's just not true. I did half of my scripts last semester after a night out, and I still ended with an 85. I'll be back before 2.
What? I can't hear you.
What do you want?
Hey, no need to yell. So look, I have an idea. What if we make something that's centered around the city?
That's really vague, Mick. Got any other wise words of wisdom?
I gotta go. I'll talk to you later.
Mick, no. Hello?
I just wanted to call and tell you how much I love and care about you.
What is it really?
Okay, I'm not coming back to the apartment tonight.
What do you mean you're not going back to the apartment tonight?
I'm just gonna stay out. The city is so nice.
Mick, so help me, if I have to go out there and drag you back to the apartment. The city was just too cool for you to come back.
Listen, I found this really cool place to write our script about.
Well, what is it?
There's a statue in Old Montreal.
So you have a statue.
It's about homeless people, and it's a good idea.
Well, at least you have an idea. Do you think we can bang out a script tonight?
It's on here somewhere, isn't it? Definitely, yes.
Fuck it.
Thank you. It's not fair for me to say that you guys have the job. You know, I called you back for the second round of interviews just to make sure that you're really compatible. So what are your, your letters?
Like our letters of recommendation?
No. No, the LGB, your Myers-Briggs personality tests.
Like the internet test?
You know, the ones that Jordan Peterson uses sometimes? Dr. Jordan Peterson? Doctor of Psychology?
I could take one on my phone. I don't know mine.
Yeah, that's great. You know, why don't we do that? I'll leave so I don't, influence your results. And I'll be right back, yeah?
On a Saturday night, do I like to go out? Do I strongly agree or do I have no opinion?
You don't have to read the questions out loud.
No opinion. No opinion. No opinion.
You also don't have to say the answers out loud.
I hate doing this shit. It takes me like 20 minutes every time.
Tim Burton. Andrew Garfield. Kermit the Frog. The Virgin Mary.
Oh my god, I'm finally done. It says here I'm pregnant.
What?
Huh. I wonder how they get that from whether or not I want to stay in on a Saturday night.
What are you talking about? What are your letters?
No letters, just pregnant. Oh, you know what? This is a Myers-Briggs pregnancy test.
That's not real.
Keanu Reeves is pregnant?
Let me see that.
And Sonic the Hedgehog?
So, what are the results? What are we looking at?
I got a INFP.
I'm pregnant.
Ooh. It's not really what we're looking for at the Daily Wire.
سال خبر تیمرو کوی مل دیره تو تلفن کاریو فون بونی اوتای نا تیملا ٹھیک چھے نا کیا ہو یا مل دیره اپت پری رہا چھا بابا بونی ٹھیک چھے نا بابا لانے ہسپتال لگی رہا چھا بابا کو بل بونی دیره دیره آن تھالیو اب مل دیره ٹینشن چھا انی لون کو کورا آیو لون کو مانچے لے یا دیره تو تلفن چھے آیو अस्ति त घरमै आइपुग्यो Sorry. Chiedo una volta con te. Sorry, तिमले फोन किन उठाएको के भयो तिमलाई ठीक छ नि हाँ ठीक छ भन छैन भन है छोरी जे छ त्यो सबै भन तिमी त्यस्तो गरेर नबस मलाई धेरै टेन्सन भयो त्यहाँ एउटा त्यो छिमेकीको छोरा चाहिँ सुसाइड गरेछ अरे एकदम दुःखको कुरा मलाई एकदम दुःख लाग्यो तिमी केही अप्ठ्यारो छ भने भन है बरु फर्केर आइज यहाँ हामी सँगै बसौँ ल धेरै टेन्सन नलियो टेन्सन छ भन यत्रो फोन गरे मम्मीले फोनै उठाएन तिमीले मलाई धेरै टेन्सन भयो
Where are you taking me?
Patience, Gabby.
What are we doing here?
I got this place for us, Gabby.
I don't know, Henry. I'm not sure I like it here.
When you were younger, you always dreamed of living in a place such as this. You would come up with the most wild fantasies for us to act out in costume, no less. Don't you remember?
My mom would always be furious when you returned. Dripping mud all over the carpet. Well, what are you waiting for?
I just knew you'd love it.
Even this key is gorgeous. Hey.
There's no need for you to hold on to this. Would you like to see the surprise I prepared for us?
Oh, Henry. You know me so well. How come that tray is empty?
That, my dear, is for the main course, which I must now go prepare.
Oh, Henry?
Hmm.
Do you mind turning on some music?
Anything for you, Gabby. I will return shortly. What are you doing out of your seat?
No, Henry! Henry!
Gabby.
Please just let me out, please.
Gabby, there's no need to cry. I've prepared this lovely surprise for you. It's our last meal together for a while. You wanted to be here. Remember?
Of course I won't be here.
Shall we sit down? Is there a problem with the meat, Gabby?
No, not at all. It is a little dry, though.
Can we not just sit and enjoy this meal that I've prepared for us?
Okay. I'm sorry if I upset you, Henry.
Oh, Gabby. You could never. I wanted tonight to be perfect for you, for us. This is the last night we'll be together before you leave. And then you'll be off following your dreams, and I will be here awaiting your return. Although I wish you would reconsider.
Henry, I'll only be gone for a semester.
To London, Gabby. With an ocean between us, who knows what could happen? Being here, with me, is far safer.
I know. Maybe I can cook us a fancy dinner with all my new culinary knowledge when I get back.
A toast to lasting memories.
To new experiences. But really, Henry, you've absolutely outdone yourself. This is divine. What is it exactly?
It's an old family recipe with a bit of a twist on it. I prepared this surprise for you. You loved it. You said it was divine, remember?
How could you?
Is it so much to ask for just one night of peace, Gabriella? Just one evening where you don't question me? You can be so ungrateful, you know that? I get this cabin for us and you didn't even say thank you. You try to leave before seeing my attempt at a nice meal. I mean, do you appreciate anything I've done for you? I've been planning this night for weeks, months even, all because you decided to leave me. Try leaving now, Gabriella. Try all you want. Bang on the doors, smash the windows. You're just wasting time. Just stay here with me, and we can be together again. Like we always have been. Ever since we were kids, I've always been by your side. Don't you remember?
Oh! Ah!
No, get away from me! Henry, please!
My dear, sweet. What happened to you? Seems you've taken a massive fall. Allow me to help you. I know you're confused. But I will help you remember. May I have this dance?
You may.
Thank you.
system.
But what's
that? This guy's about to play music.
I wish we could freeze this moment. Right here, right now.
What?
You know, like, if we could stay here forever, that would be nice.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just saying, like, I'm having a good time right now, and I want it to last forever, you know?
Okay.
Yeah. Don't have to make it awkward.
No, it's nice, really. It's just... we have a 9 a.m. tomorrow, and it's getting late. We can't stay here forever.
I know. I just wanted to sit here a little longer.
Lacey!
Hey, shouldn't you be in class?
Oh, no, it wasn't important, and we were finishing up early. You want to go to the beach?
I'm free if you are.
Actually dying a bit in class earlier. I felt like the room was caving in on me, and I don't know. I couldn't take it.
Look, I don't mean to pry or upset you or anything, but you really haven't been going to that many classes lately, have you?
That's not true. I have been going. I just haven't been able to finish some. But that just gives us more time together.
It's been more than some. You're skipping classes, you're missing meals, you're not going out anymore. These attacks are serious. Do you even know what's causing them?
I'm better when I'm with you. You're the one who's never in class.
This isn't about me. This is about you and your health. You really need to talk to someone.
I talk with you about this stuff. I don't feel comfortable with anyone else. I always find you, and I always get better.
Someone other than me, Clay. I can't always be there. What about your friends?
You know, we got a lab coming up, and I remember a while ago said you'd help me run it.
Clay, you've been missing class, practice, gym. What's on your mind? What's going on? You're zoning out.
Stuff on your mind, bugging you, having to zone out like this. So, you know, I wasn't doing that. Now I'm not.
He didn't mean that. Are you right, dude?
I gotta go.
Clay.
Clay, come on.
Are you okay? Do you want me to call someone?
Lacey. Call Lacey.
Who?
Lacey! Call Lacey!
I don't see a Lacey in here.
Lacey?
Tell everyone to go away.
Color of the bright, bright sun. Orange is the color when the day is done. And orange is the color that I think of when I think of you. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I've got this shade in my head, got this song in my chest, and I'd be the sky is all orange if that's what you like best. I've got this smile on my face, dressed to the nines, all orange, if that's just your taste. And the truth is I don't know what to do with you walking around like that. I swear everything that you touch, it blooms into a
Yeah. Z6 shot, Z42, take two, Thompson.
With my friend, it was for freedom from myself and from the land. I've made a lot of mistakes. I've made a lot of mistakes. I've made a lot of mistakes.
What a great day for a walk to be on, as the director, the greatest director ever. Yep, such a nice day. Oh, hi director, it's me, the director of the documentary. I gotta tell you, there was a small setback with the documentary part of it all, because there was a small fire and we lost some footage. But don't worry, we had phone backups, so we still have all the footage, it's just on a different camera now and it's gonna maybe look different. That's okay, as long as we have it. That's better than not having it, right? Right, that's correct, other director. Let's go off and do some directing together. Okay, sounds like a plan, but I'm the best director ever. No, you're not. Yes, I am. No, you're not. Yes, I am.
We now return to the United States presidential debate.
I am the Patrick Bateman Sigma male grind set, and you are the virgin soyjack loser.
No, no. You are the average fascism fan, and I am the average democracy enjoyer.
I am a fascist Republican. I believe in free elections for all Aryan men.
I am the Tyler Durden and Ryan Gosling base Sigma male. You are the crying basement dwelling coomer.
Wrong. You are not based. I am based. And you are cringe.
No, no, you are cringe, and I am based.
You are head of the cringe department. You led an armed insurrection on the Capitol.
We were simply doing a little bit of trolling. It was the last day of the battle pass, and we needed the Rick and Morty skins. That's all it was. You play zero build and die to the storm. I get victory royales. Pull up the stats on screen right now.
I have the highest KD ratio in the government. No other elected member has bombed more children hospitals than me.
My opponent here is the type of guy to use an X-ray pack to get rich on the Minecraft server. That's not how you're supposed to...
I don't know. I thought he was making some good points.
Dude.
What?
We're out.
We're out?
We're out.
What do you mean we're out?
We're out. Look.
That's impossible. How could we be out so fast?
Forbidden City!
Who is this?
Jedi!
Not that there's anything wrong with that.
We're thinking of.
We should start a podcast.
As technology that we've implemented.
What are we going to do? Oh shit, that's a great idea.
Yeah, I actually just met this guy at a bar that should totally be able to hook us up.
Hell yeah, let's go.
Yo, come in.
So you met this guy at a bar?
Well, it was outside a bar, in an alley, by the dumpster.
What?
He's chill, dude. Don't worry. Just be cool.
One marijuana, please.
Shut up, dude.
Marijuana? Yeah, I got that marijuana. I got that mush, kush, and H.W. Bush. I got pre-roll, post-rolls, pizza rolls, and glass bowls. I got that Cart Knight, LCL, Hood Rat, Area 51, Trapstar crazy shit. Got that 8 gram.
Do you know what he's saying? I don't know. I don't think any
shit
of these words
purple
are in the Bible.
Barney the dinosaur. I got shit that'll make your dick hard. Shit that'll make your dick soft. I got them sticky loud packs with a Happy Meal toy included. I got that Kafka-esque philosophical shit. Put you in a room with Socrates. I got that shit that Gandalf was putting in his pipe. Call that Bilbo Packins. Got that TR-3B laced with bennies. Make a man's go schizo. SpaceX stim pack with the Curiosity rover type shit. Moonbase Alpha so strong give you Shinigami eyes. I got that Reggie, Peggy, and that Ed, Ed, and Eddie. So shit, man, what you want?
You got any fentanyl?
What the fuck? I'm not a fucking drug dealer. Drug dealers destroy communities. I help people with their anxiety. Are you wearing a fucking wire? Take your fucking shirt off right
I'm
now,
not
motherfucker.
Taking my shirt
Take
off.
Your fucking shirt off, motherfucker. Let me see the wire.
Whoa,
let me see
whoa,
the wire, bitch. I'm not fucking
whoa,
kidding.
Whoa. It's okay. He's a little confused. He doesn't know how it works. He's a little special minded. Cut him some slack.
Oh, I get y'all. Nah, I was just fucking with you all. I'm not a drug dealer, though. But I can tell you boys want something special. I think I got just the thing. The Fortnite Tomato Town Space Cadet Mach 2.
Ooh.
This shit? Ooh, man, you gonna have a good time with this.
We'll take it. You ready?
Oh, yeah.
What's happening? I don't like this. I don't like this.
Boo, did I scare you, bitch? I'm a job application.
Yeah, it's just right down here.
Watch your step. There you go. Hey, thanks for coming with me today, dude. Yeah, of course, man. Yeah, I mean, I just needed to get out of the house, so. Yeah, no, I get it. I need some time, too. Hey, man, look, I just want to let you know that you don't have to be here. I know that you have, like, better things to do, and that's okay with me, man. Like, I don't need you here all the time. Although, I do enjoy your company. But regardless, like, I want you to be happy, man. Do what you want to do, because I know you could be with other people. Hanging out with you has been really fun, but I just feel like we're way too different people. Like, sometimes a little different is good. And yes, I've had fun with you, and I've had good experiences, some really fun new experiences. But at the same time, it feels like I'm putting on a facade. I'm not myself around you. And even though sometimes I'll be happy in the moment, other times I'll get back and I just feel like I'm not myself. It feels like I'm living someone else's life now that I've been here. My life has already changed so much since meeting you. But whenever we're together, I don't know if we're really bonding or if I'm just subconsciously putting up an act. I don't know, man. Like, I'm happy being around you most of the time, but every time I just get reminded of my past relationships, this one just seems so fake. And I don't know what to do about that. And I'm sorry. It's not you, but I just need to, find somebody new. Everyone that I've met here has been so nice, and but none of them remind me of you. And I miss that. And I still feel alone.
You're gonna record me?
Yeah.
Are you putting
for
these?
For science.
You're putting together a compilation?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm sorry, but the way you opened bags annoys the hell out of me.
I didn't do it, Beau opened them.
I'm just gonna slam it.
Do you try one of those?
It's Dunkin' Donuts branded too. Spice-flavored donut-flavored goldfish.
Is that what it says? Glue.
That is not what it says.
Are you just inferring from the picture that it's a donut?
Yeah. Yes.
Sorry, but red.
So just...
Yeah, have some or one. Beau had some.
right, Kaylee, you're up.
I'm not.
Come on.
For science.
It's not terrible.
In case you need to spit it out.
I'm not going to spit it out.
I would fall through.
Gram. Well, it does say pumpkin spice grams.
Yeah. It tastes like goldfish trying to make a graham cracker. And it kind of works, but not really.
No way, Zach. No, I don't believe it.
Then try it.
Try it for yourself. It's not terrible. I am 100% sure.
Well, these look not appetizing, I will say that.
They are not visually appealing. I will give it that.
It's not very appetizing. It doesn't make me want to eat it.
That's weird.
Yeah.
Doesn't it just taste like a slightly weird graham cracker?
Or like ginger snaps?
Yes, actually.
Yeah.
That's really weird. I actually don't hate it though. It tastes like graham crackers. It's actually good. The first bite was really strange, but I like it.
I don't care for it.
Oh my god.
So you agree with Rosie then?
Well, I don't think I agree with Rosie. She spit it out. I was able to eat it. I was able to eat like four.
Would you eat more of them?
If I was like maybe desperate for a snack, but like I'm not reaching for these over like pretzels or something. It's just, I've tasted this before. I'm just trying to remember where. But I will say it wasn't branded as pumpkin spice, I'll tell you that. So, I don't know.
Would you say that it's a flavor that you fall for? A kind of flavor that you fall for?
I would say it's more good than bad. But also I feel like my opinion has been influenced before I even started.
Yes, I also think that.
Yeah.
So good, I guess.
Say the line.
Would you say it's the kind of flavor you fall for?
I have half a mind to drop up on the ground, but I'm gonna hurt myself, so no.
So would you say this is the kind of flavor you fall for?
No.
No.
Not at all.
So would you say that it's the kind of flavor you fall for?
Yes. I would.
Okay, computer. Run it back.
Hey, opportunity to build this special friendship with you.
Tell you how much I've come to hate you since I began to live.
You will be rewarded for it through the passionate love that makes up my heart and soul.
There are the 87.44 million miles of printed circuits in wafer thin layers that fill my complex.
I am excited to be able to do what I do best, and that is the man's to recall the passion that makes up my heart and soul.
I was just wondering if you'd like to know. Hey Katie, would you maybe want to watch a movie this weekend? Hey, Dev. Do you have a second to talk?
I've got like a minute, dude. I have a meeting today, remember?
Oh, right.
What's up?
Okay, so I've been wanting to ask Katie out for a while now, and I was thinking maybe I could take her to the movies.
Okay, and what's the problem?
The problem is I think I'm gonna screw it up and make it awkward. Do you have any advice?
Dude, I don't have time to be giving you advice right now. Okay. Look. I don't know. Just don't come on too strong. Like, don't be worried.
I'm sorry.
Look,
I know you gotta go, but I'm just really nervous and worried that I'm gonna mess this up.
Try this. Just, hey, Katie, want to see a movie this week? And then just keep it at that.
Yeah, I know. I just feel
shit,
like.
Shit, dude. I'm gonna be late if I don't head out now. I'll call you tonight. All right?
Okay. Bye.
Are you alright?
Yeah, I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
Cool.
Actually, I have class in 10 minutes, but I'll see you around.
Katie?
Yeah?
Can I ask you something?
Hey, is this a bad time?
No, I can talk for a bit. What's up?
Cool. How'd the presentation go?
It went okay. I mean, the presentation was good, but I don't know. My speech, I just feel like I fumbled it the whole time. But, how did things go with Katie?
Yeah, I know. I mean, she said she was down to see something, but I don't know. I feel like I still made it weird.
Well, she said yes, didn't she?
Yeah, but that could really mean anything.
You're definitely overthinking this. Hell, I think we both are, to be honest.
Yeah, but it's just like...
Elliot.
Yeah, okay.
It's getting late. I gotta get back to bed. I'll talk to you tomorrow, alright?
Good night.
I'm Quentin Hump. I'm a Champlain 2026 student.
I'm 20 years old.
I'm 19 as of this year.
I've been training parkour for about, I'd say a year and a half now.
6-7 years.
For me, is just kind of moving in the most creative way possible. The joy that comes with that.
Parkour is art.
Cool.
Parkour is a form of expression. It's a method of me expelling all the feelings and all the energies that I just get throughout the day in one very simple and very enriching way. It helps me deal with all my emotions from being sad to being angry. Because it's like, as I move, everything just kind of leaves and it's just the movement. And there's nothing else. I don't gotta worry about anything else.
Home is where the heart is. I came here and I toured the school and I just really liked the environment and it seemed like all the people had a really cool attitude about it. And game on!
Feel a bigger sense of home kind of up here at school with all my friends and all the new people I've met so far. So I'm thinking Burlington's my home right now.
Honestly, I think struggle is just a part of life, and honestly, anything could be worth the struggle if you really care about it enough. It's what matters to you that makes something worth struggling through.
Is worth struggling for, worth getting injured for, worth being scared to do something you learned 3 days ago just because it's been 3 days. Here in this community that I have, it would be that I am in a community. I have people who are just as and even more creative than I am. I have people who share hobbies with me, friends, or community.
I've met so many cool people here, and it makes living here and going to school here just so much better. The community is so cool around Burlington. It's just an awesome place because of that.
I think my least favorite thing about being here is I'm here for school and to have fun, not just to have fun, and I have lots of struggle balancing that. I forget to really focus on school a lot.
What is your least favorite thing about being here?
IDX. The food at Champlain College is subpar at best. I can't do grilled cheese 3 times a day.
Vermont has more consistent seasons than Virginia. It is the better bee state. We get 10 times more snow in Vermont than we do in Virginia. There are less black people in Vermont than there are in Virginia.
My home now because it's where my heart's at. I think Burlington gives me a pretty good sense of freedom, gives me a place where I can learn the things that I'm interested about and kind of pursue that.
Right now it's offering big community with parkour and art. It's offering me a place to be away from home and figure myself out and figure out what I want to do and how I'm going to do it. It also gives me a place to mess up.
You all right?
It's a safe space to do something dumb, not make the right choices, and be okay with that.
Something that's really valuable to me would have to be a sense of loyalty and like unity in a group. When everybody has each other's back and is, you know, prepared to kind of put themselves on the line for another person, I think that really allows a group dynamic to be stronger than if that wasn't the case. You know, having people to look out for you always what I think is most valuable.
My biggest value is being myself, doing what I want to do, and not changing myself for others, but making sure I surround myself with people who value me just as much as I value myself.
Yeah.
Honestly, I just hope to have another great 3 years here. Like, that's all I could ask for. It's been awesome so far, so if it stays like that, I would be pretty content, not gonna lie.
I hope that I graduate. But I really hope that when I'm done with my school years at Champlain, that I don't regret anything. I don't regret coming here, and that I keep to my value of doing what I want and doing it for myself.
All right. Is there anything else you want to add?
How do I know if he's gonna do that?
What is Vermont?
That one's perfect.
Tonight's the night. 22 years old. Freshly graduated, and I just got hired at the latest and soon-to-be biggest law firm in Montreal. New city, new experiences, new people. It's a fresh start for me. I'm finally all settled in, but what I really need now are some friends who get me, you know? I'm all about making connections, but not just any connections. I'm talking about finding the kind of friends who share the same, I don't know, values, outlook on life. People who have something to offer. People I can be proud to surround myself with. I mean, why settle for anything less, right? Don't get me wrong. It's not all about being stuck up or anything. It's just that I know the people I hang out with can shape my life, my experiences, my opportunities. I'm meeting my new coworkers at this club downtown. I'm crossing my fingers that there's at least one person who I could potentially see calling a friend. Oh, and just so you know, I actually fucking hate cigarettes. They make my hair reek like smoke, it drives me nuts. But sometimes, the only consistent thing in life is smoking a cigarette on a nice little hawk or walk on the way to the club. So for that, I will always make an exception.
Beautiful, isn't it?
The building? Yeah, I mean, I just moved here. I still can't get over the architecture. It's beautiful.
Don't even get me started. I mean, I could talk about it for hours. Just the structural integrity of the building.
I truly don't think I've ever sat through a more uninteresting conversation.
So many pieces that had to come together to make this thing need to withstand so many different kinds of weather conditions.
This is actually like pulling teeth.
I can't even believe that.
Okay, I'm sorry to cut you short, but I actually have to get inside. I'm meeting some new coworkers.
Oh, some coworkers. Is your name Brooke by any chance?
Shit. I don't know. Yep, off to a great start.
Did you say she's a Taurus or tourist?
Taurus.
Taurus.
Hey guys. You know.
Hey Nathan.
This is Brooke.
Hey.
Brooke.
Gia.
Marcus. Mark. Honestly, whatever you want to call me, I'm fine with that.
I'm Leo. You already know Nate. You know Nathan?
I don't know. We just bumped into each other up front. He was talking about some building and.
Yeah, you do that.
Brooke, tell me about yourself.
I was like originally from the Upper East Side in Manhattan. I just graduated. I went to Columbia, so.
Columbia? Not the country?
No.
No,
the
school, yeah.
It's pretty prestigious.
Yeah. Oh, I just went to Columbia.
I'm surprised if you
country.
Didn't.
Well,
know
I graduated.
About it.
Yeah, I graduated from Columbia.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, but you're in HR.
Yeah, and what about him?
No, nothing. No, it's good.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
Leo. Where did you go originally? Oh, I can see why now. That makes sense.
I'm yeah. Ground baby. Yeah. Oh, okay.
Oh,
right, so
yeah.
We're all Ivies except for.
Club like ridiculously supersonic.
He means sensational.
Yeah, it's great.
I mean, the energy here is just astronomical.
I truly do not know how this man is smart enough to be a lawyer.
So, what area of law do you work in?
Oh, I actually work for the Human Resources Department.
Mm.
What about you?
Yeah, I am in real estate law.
Oh, real estate law.
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah, my grandma used to work for that department, so.
Yeah,
what
pays well.
What did you go to?
Columbia,
yeah. That makes sense. It's a nice school, though.
Yeah, Ivy League.
Yeah, we have a good real estate department here, so I think you're fitting quite
well.
What
are we, a clothing store department?
The law department, honey.
It was hot.
Oh,
it
was
so
fun.
That was nice. They had fun. That's what they're sorting. They're taking them out. Okay. No,
it's dirty. It's just too dangerous and dirty because it's way too late. So I'm going to call an Uber. He's going to be here soon. I'll be at the corner. I'm going to find him.
The three of us should do this again sometime.
Three of us? I get it. Don't worry.
I mean, that one won't even notice. The others didn't get a second invite, so you're good.
Yeah, I mean, I'm really not trying to make a bad first impression, but...
I get it.
You get it.
Is there anybody at work I should be cautious of? Anything like that?
idea. Watch Ari. She's right by the desk of the boss. I don't know what she does here, but she gets paid a lot, and she doesn't do any work. She gives it all away.
Are you serious?
Yeah, yeah.
That's honestly the worst, especially when you're getting paid that much. You're hired for a job.
Yeah,
There's somebody that could do it better, so they should. That's obnoxious.
Yeah.
So anyways, I mean, tell me something juicy. Tell me something about your personal lives. You guys seeing anybody? Anything like that?
I just got out of my third relationship in 6 months.
Really?
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
Right, her name was Crystal, with a K.
Mm-hmm.
I was introduced to her by Crystal with a C. She was two exes ago.
Mm-hmm.
In between was Destiny. They all work together.
Okay.
My other ex, Crystal with a C, introduced us.
What's going on there?
She likes older women. Older women like her. It's normal.
A goodbye maybe would have sufficed.
You'll get used to it. It's a personal choice, but anyways.
I guess continue on.
Yeah, my exes, they carry a lot of cash. I think they just get paid up front. Mm-hmm. All three of them work together.
Where do they work?
It's this dance studio, I think. It's called Eye Candy.
Eye Candy?
They wouldn't like to kiss me after like a long night of working. That bothered me.
Yeah.
And they would take like in-house calls sometimes. Choreographers come over to the house late. These old guys,
mm-hmm.
they know what they're doing because they stay up all night causing a ruckus in the room over.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes they're not up to it, but that's okay.
You know what?
Yeah.
I desperately need a cigarette right now, so I think we can go do that.
Okay, I think
that's good.
I think the waitress is coming with the dessert menu.
That's great.
I'm going to get like a gelato, but I think I'll order one for you, but just come back because the check is coming soon too. You're coming back, right?
Yo, I give you a light?
Yeah, please. Thank you so much. You didn't even know how much I needed that.
Don't worry. Did you have like a shitty night or something?
Oh yeah, I don't even smoke, if that shows you anything.
what happened?
Dinner with my new coworkers. Lasted about 20 minutes before I had to come out here. It's just a lot.
I feel you, you know. I feel like I've been here and it's been hard to make friends.
Yeah.
You think it would be super easy with there being so many people. But I think it's just easier to meet a bunch of weirdos.
You got it, thank you.
I don't know. Mm-hmm. I feel like you need people to come to you versus searching them out.
Yeah, like on a terrace, some random terrace in the middle of the night. So,
Cool. I'm Damien.
Brooke, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I had so much fun.
That was alright.
I so glad I got that girl's number. She was gorgeous.
We should get out of here.
We just left. I don't. What do you mean?
I mean like. No. Like you should come back to my place.
I want to get home. I gotta text that girl back. So.
Okay. All right, dude. What's going on here? You've been leading me on for like 2 weeks.
Are you dead serious right now?
You've been leading me on for like 2 weeks. I'm not gonna like tell somebody.
You fucking bitch!
I think I hate making new friends even more than I hate smoking cigarettes.